could really see just how massive the animal actually was. The closed distance between us within seconds. Could have reached out and grabbed me by my hair. You can't freeze. You cannot freeze in a moment like that, because if you freeze, you die. From the Twin Cities of Minnesota. Basically grew up out in the woods from a young age. My dad started me with like firearm safety to get me ready for hunting when I was 11 or 12. I've been doing that ever since. I've always liked it. It's always been fun to just be out there. The cabin is located in a town that's not far from Siren, Wisconsin, in northwestern Wisconsin. We would go up there several times a year, especially during the summer. It's literally just surrounded in miles and miles of thick forest. It's the middle of nowhere. Once it got dark there, it was spooky. It was a scary area to be in. For years, we would have campfires in the fire pit. And from the fire pit, you can look up the hill that goes to that tree line, and it'd feel like at night, like there was something watching you. It always felt like their eyes just locked onto you from up there. You didn't want to wander around those woods at night. My mom, she always felt the same way. Day, I was hanging out with my cousin. Ow! He was about my age. I decided to go and have ourselves a little battle, going around with BB guns that shoot plastic BBs. It's a fun game, but it doesn't feel good to get hit by those BBs because they fly pretty fast. I was more into it than my cousin was. He dressed in regular plain clothes. I had an old army woodland camouflage. And I figured, hey, camouflage, woods, they go hand in hand. And then I retreated to the wood line to try to utilize the camouflage. He was chasing me into the woods. As I was bouncing from cover to cover, he would shoot, I would duck, and then I would shoot and he would duck. Every once in a while, we'd get hit. I would crouch, stay low, try to stay less visible, kind of like I was hunting.
Hey, let's not go too far into the woods, John.
We were at the top of a hill where there's a slight clearing in the wood line where you can see for a good 50, 60 yards.
Time out!
I called time out because mostly I was winded. I was tired from running. And I figured, hey, let's take a break.
I got you good in your dreams.
I noticed that the woods were dead quiet. All the birds had stopped chirping. It clicked in my head that there's something wrong here.
What?
When the woods go quiet, it typically means there is a large predator nearby. whether it be a bear, mountain lion. It's something that I'm familiar with because I've had multiple encounters with predators in the woods, and it's a terrifying experience. I began to look from left to right across this clearing because I had the feeling of being watched. I was expecting a bear was the most likely option. When I went from right to left, about halfway is when I locked onto it, when I saw it. What stood out was white, and I saw the white focused, and it was teeth, large canine teeth. And it had massive jaws. I could really see just how massive the animal actually was. I saw its eyes, the way that it was looking at us, it was like daggers. It was darting its eyes between my cousin and me. I tensed up immediately. I did not want to deal with this situation. You can't freeze. You cannot freeze in a moment like that, because if you freeze, you die. It sounded like a close distance between us within seconds. I could hear it directly behind me. My cousin has stopped.
Let's go!
Just keep going. I'm right behind him. This thing is right on me. Close enough to where it could have reached out and grabbed me by my hair. Once we cleared the tree line, we stopped hearing the animal, and we ran straight for the cabins.
What was that?
He seemed about as freaked out as I did, and at that point, I didn't know what to say, so I told him it was a bear, because I knew that my grandparents who were with us would not believe any of that. The first person I told was my mother.
It wasn't a bear, Mom. It was something else.
She said it brought back bad memories for her.
I've seen one.
She told me she had seen one as well, in the same area of Wisconsin. Said that an animal began crossing the road. The size of the animal was more than twice the size of a regular wolf. She described the way that the creature had moved as being unnatural. It looked like it was uncomfortable in its own feet. It looked right at her vehicle, like it wanted to scare the living crap out of her. It immediately charged the car. She believed that what she was looking at was pure evil, and decided to break off and run into the woods. In the research I've done, I find out that people are calling these dogmen. Personally, I find the name to be a little silly, but I think that it matches the descriptions of what the other eyewitnesses have seen. I believe that this creature was in the woods waiting for us. It was an uncomfortable feeling to have, to realize, oh, hey, there's something out here that is likely as intelligent as I am, and it's hunting. After the encounter, I was way more cautious when going out into those woods. I didn't want to take the chance of having to outrun something like that again.